All the books here are related to each other, as well as downstairs. You know, look at this, you know, this kind of cover, you know. That's super rare stuff. Again, by Amal Hachette, they are all my favorite, you know. For me, they are part of my eyes and memory. I mean, I cherish them. I take an incredible care of them. I would never play them anymore. They are digitized and I don't touch them.
The love of music has been in me since childhood. Usually people buy clothing, shoes, you know, things like that. The first thing I bought was a record player from an American guy who was living in Ethiopia.
Thank you. Yeah, that was Cole Porter, way back though.
And that's how it all started.
This was a very flourishing city, you know? It's like a modern city.
It was very open, you know? We were able to buy Newsweek and all kinds of international papers. We were able to know about musicians in other countries of the world, who are the great musicians in Africa, in Europe, and in America as well.
You know, when they play, pa, wow, what kind of thing is this? And then I try to catch up. And I mean, whenever I find the drums, I try to catch up with the rhythm they play at that time.
The nightlife was great. People were going out basically, you know, 7 nights a week. I had a part-time job at the American Mapping Mission, which gave me a chance to go Kanyao Station. In Kanyao Station, they had an FM radio station. They had latest music, James Brown, Elvis Presley. I was totally fascinated. And I said to myself, if these things are released in the US, why aren't they available in Ethiopia? I said, I have to do something. I have to give something to these people. My first order of LPs and 45s from the United States arrived. Some people thought it was crazy. But that very, very night, I had the records come in, maybe at around 4 o'clock in the afternoon, half the shelves were empty. After a week, the whole shelf was completely empty. It was an empty store. I was the first person who had music show. There was no one else.
When the music, new music comes, you know, you stand there, you stand there. You listen all the new songs, you know. If you can't afford to buy, you stand there all day, you listen, whatever you want.
A lot of rock and roll, basically. It was Elvis time, rock and roll things, you know.
He was so fast, you know. He had a lot of collection. He knows what the people want, you know.
You know, in life, one thing always leads you to something else. What I started asking myself was something that I have never thought about before. I'm selling Sudanese records, Italian records, American, of course, Indian, but there is no Ethiopian music. I said, what is going on here? The emperor was a very powerful person. He was respected. The security force was tough. You know, you can be put in jail and be thrown out and then be forgotten. I found out that the emperor had put a decree giving the right of publishing any record to Patriotic Association. With that decree on hand, most people were not willing to go along with me. They were afraid.
ለመንግስት ነው የምንሰራው ለመንግስት በወር ትንሽ ደሞዝ ይሰጣል ኮምፖዝ ያደርጉልሃል ሙዚቃ ታጠናለህ ዝፈን ሲሉ ትዘፍናለህ የወር ደሞዝ ሰራተኛ ነህ ማለት ነው እንደ አርቲስት አይደለም
አማ he told me about an idea to make a recording the first recording and he wants me to play the music how come I do it and Alma you say you have to do it this is our music and I know you can do it and he convinced me and then
I said I will take a chance if this is my destiny to go to jail let it be Amazingly, there were people interested in having a shekla, and officially they let us a studio at the Ministry of Information. Everyone pushing each other, saxophone, trumpet, organ, drum, vocalist, but we made it. Sent the tape to the company, a real tape, master tape. Then another problem, another obstacle. This thing would come through customs, through the airport. This is the Ethiopian record written in Amharic. And all these people know that you can't record Ethiopian shekla. That was the final cut-off point where they could say, oh, this is illegal, you can't bring Ethiopian music. But you know, amazingly, the only thing they asked me is if I can give them a copy. They could have stopped everything. They could have just burned the whole thing and put us to jail. The whole place, the piazza, was jammed with people. And people were dancing on the streets, and the street was basically blocked. This is a miracle. Okay.
በእኛ ዘመን እንግዲህ የመጀመሪያው ስራ ስለነበረ አድናቆት ነው።
People are saying, you know, these people are having a time of their life. You know, Alamayo is more popular than ever. Girma was doing well. He's wearing nice shirts. He's driving a nice car.
For about 1 year, I was rich, though.
I was rich, though.
But I'm through. I'm through again and again, again and again. And I'm through an artist.
From 1969 to 1975, I was able to do about, you know, 102 45s and some 12 or 14 LPs. Life was great. That is how I remember. The emperor was getting old. There was tension, there was fear and happiness. I was happy that there was going to be a change. I never thought or I never knew what kind of change there was going to come. We never thought there would be total civil war. They said, you know, land to the tiller was fine. When they had this property and stuff like that, you know, taken, it was fine. When they imprisoned the prime minister and stuff, it was okay. The minute they killed the 60 government officials and buried them in one big hole, that was when I said, this is not going to be a good change.
Oh.
ተቋጥሮ ተይዞ ነበር ተወጥሮ ነበር እንደ ልቡ ሙዚቃ ሊሄድ አልቻለም ነበር
totally ruined nightlife. The final years of my records pressing was done in Athens. They gave me an exit visa. I went to Athens. Then my family sent me a telegram saying, you know, don't come back. My father was put in jail. The vocalist was put in jail. The worst thing, they put the guy who was behind the mixer. He was just trying to adjust the sound. He was also put in jail. It was a week, it was 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Then finally I said, well, I can't stay here because I was not determined to stay. I had only, you know, limited amount of money. So I went to London. My sister was there. I stayed there another month. Nothing happened. It was getting worse. Then eventually, I went to the States. The government took all the shops that I had and sold them out. I lost everything. So that is the end of my era in the Ethiopian music business.
I was part of a non-profit organization in the mid-80s in Poitiers, France, pretty small city, like 100,000 people.
There was more fun in Poitiers than in Paris. Yeah, partying all the time, listening to great music, meeting great musicians. What else? And we were in love, Francis and I. We were very much into experimental stuff, you know, noise, rock from New York.
We wouldn't mind about inviting artists who are famous, money-making or not. We would just invite only artists we love.
They invited Sonic Youth for the first time in France. And we were crazy about that. That we liked enormously.
One day we had a party among us, and a friend of us brought LP.
We sort of saw that we were music experts a little bit. We've been listening a lot of stuff, all kind of things, really. And that was absolutely different.
I think this is, the very first simple. By the starting, it's great, you know.
Wow! Ça, c'est magnifique.
The groove is terrible. Terrible in the sense, gorgeous. Okay, you never heard that before.
We made
8 cassettes out of this LP, which we sent to friend of us, journalists, music reviewers. And by the following days, all of them called us back saying, what that? Where did you get that from?
For the first time in the story of this radio, the audience started to telephone, try to ask, what was with this title we listened 2 minutes ago or 10 minutes ago?
From them, we had the confirmation that it was unknown. Immediately, we decided to bring this guy in.
Musicale?
No, la mayo uscita in nama musica.
Gen. This is all recording and they put synthesizer and blah blah on it. It's crap. I'm sorry. The original are great, but...
Yeah, chiedi frutto per so.
Allen?
Yeah,
yesterday. Allen, wow.
I had never been to Africa. I knew a lot about various African music, but nothing about Ethiopian music. And then I landed in Addis Ababa.
The Ethiopians, they don't like strangers that much. What does this white guy want of us?
A big lesson started for me. Body check everywhere you go. You go to the post office, body check, to a hotel, body check. You could not take a walk with a photo camera, with a Walkman or recorder. You would be suspected immediately, big problem.
The best place to talk to people was in a car and just driving in the city, you know. We were sure nobody, no police here would be after us and listen to what we are doing.
I felt I was in a Stalin paradise. During this week, I've been tracing Mahmoud Ahmed.
Francis Ndenagarin, Yen Zafan, Mangala Samichel. Radio Tabiant, Ayike, Mindeno Solo, Ethiopia is the final. Bologna Gari.
I told him, look, I'm French, I'm coming from France, especially to invite you. I would be very pleased to invite you and perform in France, which was something absolutely unexpected for him.
Need a status and Tunia Lalashim Lemon, Matosita Yikain, Ethiopia music and your dream, because Ethiopia was to Katawuku, the final. And in Sita Yik, then need a status and Tunia.
He knew much better than me that it would be a hell for the administrative political process. There had national sport then, which was how to leave this country. We went in every official offices, Ministry of Culture. We went even into barracks to meet the head of the culture of the Communist Party.
Bene, mulu tasfa nebere, gin bizu tawrad nebere.
When I left Ethiopia, I thought maybe it would happen, maybe not. And as a matter of fact, very quickly I understood when I am back in France that this would not happen. Of course, the recording is rotten. It's too bad, but for me, it's proto-punk. This is 70, 69, because this song was published in December 69, I think, or 70.
ባይነት ዘር
You can write a paper about Mozart or Elvis Presley. Everybody understands what you are talking about because they can refer, they know about Elvis or Bach, Mozart or whatever. But if you write about Ethiopian music, how can you describe it? So for me, it was obvious you had to make the music itself available.
He was like obsessed with Ethiopia and Ethiopian stuff. We sort of get separated. Well, probably we were tired of each other, and I was certainly tired of the Ethiopian obsession.
Fortunately, I came with a lot of documentation, with the posters, the program. I didn't know if this one was big, that one was small.
I bought each and every vinyl I could buy.
Suddenly I had a lot of recordings that nobody had.
Through this, I understood that I had one label releasing modern music on vinyl was Amaha Records. And the owner of this label, Amaha Eshete, I understood he was in exile in America. By 86, I flew to Washington, D.C.
We met at the Washington, D.C. airport. When I think about that later on, it was a strange place to meet.
He asked me about the music that I had made while I was in Ethiopia, and he said he would like to re-release them.
He was half amazed, half, I can't believe what's going on, you know, it's a big surprise.
I said, you know, I'm in exile, I'm here. Most of the artists that I've recorded are back in Ethiopia. And I said, you know, if I record this, re-release this music, and I am here, these people would have a bad name for me. I don't know where some of them are. I don't know whether they are alive. Or whatever. So I said, you know, if God willing, if I ever come back to Ethiopia, I said, we'll then talk about it.
I understood that I could do nothing until the fall of this regime.
I was not far from music as such. I had the first full-scale Ethiopian restaurant.
He had two, three different nightclubs, as far as I understood. The last one he had was a huge, on, I don't know, three, four floors. So he was successful.
I was the first person who broke the barrier of a full band across the Atlantic from a socialist country like Ethiopia to the United States.
How can you expect bring to America from Ethiopia under the dirt a 10-piece band? You know, this is crazy.
He sent me the contract, and then the Derek said, no, You cannot go to America. I said, why? This is not a political group. These are musicians.
They were adamant that a band from a socialist country will not go to an imperial state like the United States. It took me literally 2 years to work it out.
And then they said yes. When they say yes, nobody should hear about it. You have to go secret. Nobody should hear. And nobody should accompany the airport. He just goes, okay. Then we went straight to the airport. We were scared even at the plane until it passes Ethiopian border. And then once we pass the Ethiopian border, we say, oh, now we are free.
I was so thrilled, though.
Yeah. That was great time.
This is a place where we can do what we want to do.
I like the newspaper. I like everything.
Finally happened. This is something I am really proud of myself.
Our first show was in Warner Theater.
It's one of the most popular music halls in the United States.
It was not successful.
And so in the Matoso in the Shiso, Kutaruna, Sawale Lembelachu, Satulu, Masarata Lebachu, Yemilon, Lenasuna Garquachu. Macnatum, Yegabosot in Nisalona, Yazan and Dinsar Alfaluk. Zare Casaran, Busy Waralena.
People literally cried because there was no live music at all, completely at all, nothing.
Yallene musica indalle minim santen sanader indalle kalibachin tachawten በሳምንቱ يا بيت كان برو سو إلك وده بيتو يتملى سو يبلد نبر
One year we traveled the United States.
We went from state to state, state to state.
That time, no flight. We were driving. That was the big mistake for the band, you know?
We were not doing good economically. And Amma was very tied up, he has a restaurant and things like that.
I was inexperienced about this, you know, band working in different places. There was political connotation. They thought, you know, how can Amma be able to bring this band unless he had some backing from the government.
Some people said, these are pro-Derg, don't get into their shows. We're not pro-Derg, we are not Derg, this is a private.
Everybody just get mad, you know, because there is no money.
Some of us want to go and some of us want to stay there. It was not a group thing, it was individual, I can say.
እኔ ለመቅረት ያላሰብኩት ልጆች ስለነበሩኝ ነው እዚህ ሀገር family ወይም ቤተሰብ ስላልኝ ተመልሼ መምጣት ነው
We gave them everything that we owned. We didn't come for this. We had that at home. We came for a different thing. So in fact, Girma's idea, I don't want to take anything. No instrument, no money. Okay, we said, me and Girma, we stayed. That's how the Wallace ended. It ended in America.
Real hard though for music, very hard though. To be a professional musician is really hard. Either way you have to choose, you have to play it part-time and do some other jobs.
Some became taxi drivers, some worked at the in parking places, and you know, they got to do what they got to do to lead their life.
He played in the clubs for a few years, but then he just stopped. And I still don't know why.
Koblala er dalle bat ich, sank an der Tisch. Melkisch hieß er genitz, so bekum gedeinisch. Melkisch hieß er genitz, so bekum.
She was a beautiful lady. He loved her and we heard his songs about her. So that's why he got hurted when she got sick.
In 1984, you know, my girl died. I lost my soulmate, girlfriend. I don't know what to say, but then things completely changed. That's the reason I quit, though. From fantasy to reality.
First time I saw him, I met him, I had asked around and, you know, people, he's here somewhere, but nobody will tell me where. And then one friend of mine, he said, oh, you know what? He works at this gas station on this street, crossing this street, you'll find him there.
I was refueling my car and went to pay, and there was grandmother, and I just couldn't believe my, you know, eyes. It's like, wow.
There was a change of government, I came back to Ethiopia. The main reason why I came back from the United States after 19 years was that memory was with me. The friendship we had, the love we had with friends, you know. But when I came back, it was a different story. This socialism had changed the way people lived. Forgotten completely about my initial work with music. It was my past life. And when Francis came to Ethiopia, I was surprised. After a couple of meetings, we sort of agreed that, you know, now I'm here. I will keep my word, and we can do it.
By 96, 97, when we retrieved most of the masters of AMA Records, I was empowered to pick the masters.
My goodness.
Nicest day in my life.
Mochi, as
ochi asenko nabzesh tektekena temelleshi fikri eni ligdemesh aferna dingai.
We started from there.
By October 97, I would release the very first Ethiopics.
He's been working on that for like 20 years, I think. It's been a lot of work, really, and a lot of obstination.
I had no idea at all at how it would be received by the audience on one hand and the music critics on another hand.
I was in an Ethiopian restaurant and they were playing this incredible music, and I asked the owner who it was.
Was in a cab, a taxi in Washington, and I said, what is this? What is this?
There was James Brown in there. There was like this heavy driving funk beats.
I was just blown away by how beautiful the music was, and it just turned me on completely.
It was praised as one of the best releases of 97, 98.
I told a friend of mine about them yesterday who didn't know about them, just yesterday. And I said, you're going to thank me for when you hear these records, and then you're going to curse me. I said, you're going to want all 32 volumes, because every one is a different story.
This music was completely lost. If Ethiopics was not started by Francis, forget it. Ethiopian music would have been doomed.
We became very famous in Europe, in Italy, in France. We've been all over the world.
የማውቀን የኢሮፕ ህዝብ ሁሉ እንዲያውቀን አድርገዋል more fame እንድናገኝ ሁሉ አድርገውናል.
He's like a father, he's a brother, he is a friend.
I don't think anybody has done as much as Francis has done to promote Ethiopian music.
That's the way.
I just brought to the light the top of the iceberg. It's a musical gold mine. Ethiopian music is a kind of missing link in the history of all of the musics from Africa. I'm glad that missing link is not missing anymore.
Grandma is kind of a person with, you have to manage him like a baby, you know. You know, he's not a hustler, you know. Other musicians are like a hustle, you know, they call guys, you know, let's together, let's come back here. Grandma is not like that. Grandma has a very, very unique character. Unique character. I don't know how he got into music.
Oh, God, God for him.
I messed it up. This is, sir, this is him.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay.
Matt, you got a pen, right? Mm-hmm.
Imagine you had been super famous in your country, but after it was endless fall.
I'm trying to, you know, to make a comeback. I'm not that easy, but I'll do my best, though.
I'm the one who's nagging him every time. Please, Grandma, come back.
He told me I would go back to music. That's what he said. I have to go back to music. Please, please, he was telling me.
I can play better now. But nobody believes you, though. That's the problem, though. Really comfortable though.
Anchin fagging that is the cheek. Unat meslon lipin satosh. Does not it cheek?
I think he has it in him now. I think there is so much in his body, stuffed music, that he wants to put out to the world.
Francis wrote me a letter. He was talking about Ethiopian music. And the letter was about the music revival, Ethiopian music. I read the thing and then I said, what is she talking about?
Hello, how are you doing?
How are you?
Good.
How are you?
Oh, Mercedes.
How are you doing?
Fine, and you?
Completely different, a different arrangement though. I don't even know
what it is. Yeah, brand new.
Didn't know what it is.
Yebekanya.
It's new. For real?
Yes, it's your song.
Oh, but different though.
Yeah.
Right. I don't know. I heard
kind of.
How are you doing? All right. Oh, today. So we're going to recording, right? Rehearse and rehearse.
We rehearse right. A bit and then record.
Right, right.
So what? What's it? Un peu plus glace, so what? Un peu plus glace, ouais. Tu joues la pêche sauvage ou la pêche
sauvage? That's D, right?
Yeah.
Je
crois surtout qu'Oliver va mieux comprendre si on dit la pêche sauvage. Hein? Francis, tu peux dire à Apollo de venir?
Comment?
Tu peux dire à Apollo de venir?
C'est bien 440 le piano.
To waking in dope, I won't get rain, but there's a sack, a tumble I'll change, to zetas who flew, in a fnafiaraga, una tuna grashi, bao kao di sharinya, to waking in dope, I won't get rain, but there's a sack, a tumble I'll change. My mare don't know bigger but in one the suffer ya fallo one cheek for the tank one to waking in dough I won't get ring but there's a yes such a tumble I'll cheat.
Love is a many splendid thing. Love makes you brave. I'm kind of scary, but when it comes to her, you know, I have to obey. No problem. But no one will touch her, though. I swear, no one. I'll go first. And we did it. We survived.
Je demande de faire beaucoup de bruit pour monsieur Guillermin Bayenné.
Il y a le falfois car on me dit Nekenane and the duro yemewodish a meslenye k
Because it taught you full obligation. And in what it has a because it taught you full obligation. And in what it sausage. Merci, merci. كان يا ليل بش كبر رزق راسي ست ناس كباري اني لي باي مانش على ويا متي كرون دينك يهونش وزرت اثيوبيا من تتبك علش فتصوم إثيوبيا ويت أنا ما دي ماما وزريت إثيوبيا كون جيت إني نيمبار ترامج ودت بيت وجيبا دباباي النكا ومالن أنشين بكفوي مياي
Malen, I'm in the coffee.